Hey fellow animators, I am Ilochten. Welcome to part 3 of this video series. In previous two parts, we have finished the whole rig from start to finish for Cooper here. Everything is set up now and prepared for the skinning process. So let's jump right into it and continue where we left off. Alright, one thing we could do now first is to organize all the objects we have so far. So head to Scene Explorer. And here we have a mesh group already that I have created before. But if we open the default group, all the cat objects are here. I like to have all the objects in max inside one of the groups and leave the default group empty. So that's what we will do now also. Select all the cat objects and hit the plus icon to add all of them into the new group. Or layer is what they are called here. And rename it to rig or something you like. And switch the active group to default again as it was before. That's this icon here. It means that each new object that will be created will be added to this group, which is what we want. So now we have two groups, mesh and rig, and we can hide and unhide all the objects inside of them as a whole, but also separately as well. Well, okay, that's that. Now let's hide all the meshes except for the body, and let's start by applying a skin modifier to it. We have already briefly talked about skin modifier in a previous episode, but now we are going to do it for real. So what skin does is binding every single vertex of the mesh to the bones we want to, with various weights. So it will allow us to move just the vertices of an arm, when we move the bones of an arm, for example. It will basically allow us to deform the mesh. To be able to do that, we first need to assign some bones to it. Find this Add button and select all the bones we have, except the platforms and the main cat triangle, because they are just helpers and we don't want any vertices assigned to them. So again, after doing this, if we move any bone of the rig, we can see that the mesh will move with it, because we have added the bones and because Skin Modifier has its own default values. They are usually quite bad and require a lot of editing. Default skin will always be bad, so don't worry about it just yet. We have at least something for now to do this next step. During the skinning process, we will need to see how every single vertex of the mesh deforms. We will go basically through every single vertex of the mesh and edit its weights. And for that, we need to have an animation ready, so we can just slide through the timeline and see what is being deformed and how it's being deformed. So we need to animate every single bone, moving in every single direction possible for that bone. So select any bone of the rig and head to the motion panel. Here you will find the layer manager. Here I have one layer already, which I will delete real quick, and this is how you will find it in a default state. For now, we will not worry about this too much, but I will explain a few things. What you need to know for now is that CAD has two modes, animation mode and setup mode. For switching between them, you have this button here. Right now we are in a setup mode. However, if you click the button now, nothing will happen. That's because we cannot get into the animation mode unless we have at least one animation layer created. So let's create one here and create the first type, which is an absolute layer. What all of this means is not too important at the moment. But you can see, we now already have one animation layer in the animation stack. That means we can now activate the animation mode of cat. And that means we can now start setting up keyframes for all the cat bones. All of the keys will be saved in this selected animation layer. If you would like to know more about the layers, you can watch one of my older videos here. But what you need to know for now is that when you are animating, you have to be in animation mode. And when you are doing any changes to the rig, you need to switch back to the setup mode. That's why, until now, we were in the setup mode the whole time, without you even realizing it, because we were just dealing with the rig until now. Okay, we can also rename this layer, so we know what's in it. Change it to skin test. So let's start animating. You are probably familiar with how animating works, that you set keyframes for objects and the software interpolates the movement between these keys according to the set curve between them. It's how animation works in any other software. So select every bone by double-clicking on pelvis. It's the parent of everything, so it will select all the bones, but not platforms, so select those manually as well. Turn on auto key and set a key for everything at frame 0. And let's animate. Let's set keys for like 5 frame increments for now. So at frame 5, move the leg platforms up and also rotate them. So we have something like this, and during skinning we will be able to watch the deformations just by sliding the timeline. At frame 10, legs to the back. For frame 15, Let's copy the frame 0, just so we can start from the initial pose, and let's spread the legs now. So basically we try to animate the legs to every single position that we want the rig to be able to achieve. Let's again copy frame 0, you do it by holding shift while dragging it, by the way. And this pose will be for the bum. We want to see how the bum reacts when the legs are far back, because that area is quite hard to skin right. And for frame 25, let's again copy the first frame and get the legs back to the starting position. Okay, let's continue with ankles. Set the key for them at 25. At 30, rotate them a bit, and at 35, back to the start. Same for the toes, with a difference that we want to rotate them down as well as up. Now I have realized that the keys are actually spread too much. We don't need 5 frames between everything, because then we would need like 1000 frames to animate everything we are going to, and then the timeline would be full of keys too small to select. Let's scale it to like a key every 3rd frame. If you don't have the selection range enabled under the timeline, just right click on the timeline, go to configure and check show selection range. It's good to have it enabled actually. By the way, if you like what you see here, please consider supporting me on Patreon. These videos take a very long time to make, and supporting the channel makes me invest more time into creating new videos, instead of just taking other jobs I do during the evenings and weekends. Thank you. Okay, let's take a look at the arms. We can start the animation even while legs are still moving, as they don't affect each other anyway. I will start with fingers, so double click on the palm to select all its children. And click on it again while holding Alt to remove it from the selection, because we want just the fingers. Key everything again and move the timeline. Now we animate all the fingers and all 4 of their finger bones. Bend them as much as possible and copy the first key to return them back. But I don't want all the fingers to bend at once, I want to bend them one by one. So select the first finger and we will keep the keys for this one as they are. Select the second finger and move the keys to start where the first one finished. And do the same thing for all the 5 fingers. Now they move one by one, and here you can see why I wanted that. When this middle finger moves, it also affects fingers next to it, which we don't want of course. But to be able to fix these problems, we first have to be able to see them. That's why we are doing this skin test animation. After we have this, let's select all the finger bones again and key everything in the end. Okay, we have done the animation for all 4 bones of the fingers. But we also want to see how they act when only those 3 finger bones are moving. So again, double click on the palm, but this time remove also the bones inside the palm. And now do the exact same thing as before. Offset each finger like we did a minute ago to see them animated separately. And the last thing to do here, select all the finger bones. Key all of them at this frame, now close them again as before, and back. And again for just the fingers. This is to see how the palm acts when we close all the fingers at once. Okay, now you could also add spreading of the fingers or all other movements fingers can do, but that would be too time consuming, and for what we need, this is actually enough. You can see that even this is quite time consuming to do, so let's not overdo it too much. However, it's of course true that the better the skin test animation you have, the more you can see the issues while skinning. Okay, I think you now pretty much understand what we are doing. For palm, continue where we have finished before. And 1, 2, 3, rotate it to one side. 1, 2, 3, rotate it to the other. 1, 2, 3, copy the initial frame. Rotate to the left. 1, 2, 3, to the right. We are running out of frames on the timeline, so click here and set it to a higher number. Now we have more space, but also keys are much more pushed together. That's why we don't want the animation to go for 1000 frames or so. So again, 1, 2, 3. And rotate the palm this way. Maybe even to the extreme until it snaps. And 1, 2, 3. to the other side. To finish, copy the initial key and let's move to the elbow. Don't forget to key it before we start, and again, 1, 2, 3. You can actually use a keyboard shortcut for moving the timeline. By default, it's angle brackets, those two keys next to an M. So bend the elbow, bend it to the other side. Even though it's not that important to rotate it this way, we still want to see it. Rotation to this side, however, is not even needed, so no point doing it here. What we can do are twists. One side and the other. And back to the start. Let's move to the upper arm with collarbone. And these two are actually very problematic areas to skin, because the shoulder has really a lot of possible movements, a lot of degrees of freedom. But we will get to skinning later. Now let's animate them. So this will be a bit bigger movements, so let's give it 5 frames now. And rotate the arm up. And together with also the collarbone. Now let's get back to the initial pose. And rotate the arm to the front. Like this. Now back up. But rotate it like this. Now all the way to the back. Something like this. And next, return it back to the initial pose. By the way, you will probably find out later on when skinning that you forgot to animate something. It happens every time. So maybe even we will be adding something to the animation later on, so don't worry about it too much. But still, try to think of all the moves that might be necessary, so you don't have to get back to this all the time. Okay, next, the head. Let's start with eyes. Down. Up. To the sides. You can see the default skin is terrible here, but that does not matter at the moment. Eyelids, key, 1, 2, 3, 4 for eyelids, and close them. Actually, let's just do the upper eyelid for now. And open again. Now the lower ones after that. And to finish it off, close them both at the same time. So we have upper ones, lower ones, and both together. Now the eyebrows. Actually, let's select all the eyebrow bones and key them. Now select just these little ones and move them down, to the left, to the right, get them back to the start and move them up and back. Okay. Now we will do something similar like we did with the fingers. We are going to offset them. So the first one has the keys here. The second one will start here, so move all the keys to the right and move the timeline to the end. The third one will now start here. And so on for the fourth and fifth one. So now they are separated and animating one after another. Now this bone. Down, left, right, up. We have run out of the timeline now, so let's make it longer. And back. And now the same thing for the last bone. Down, left, right, up, and back. So that's the eyelid. Somewhere during this time, we can also animate the jaw. Rotate it up, rotate it down, and back. But we can also rotate it to the sides, just to see how it will move. The teeth are simple, just move them anywhere. We just want to see any movement here to double check the skin. Let's move these diagonally actually. And the bottom ones as well. But this here is enough. For the tongue, I usually move it outside of the head just to see it better. So first move it out. Again key everything. Then rotate the tongue down. Rotate it up. Key everything and move it back again by copying the initial frame. Okay, we are almost done. Let's take a look at the pelvis helper. So move the timeline where we animated the last thing, so 320 here. We can actually move a bit back just to save some more space. And again, animate the bone rotating it down, up, left, and right. Same for the chest. Down, back, left, right, and also the twisting here. I'm going to a Thai restaurant. And exactly the same thing for the pelvis. So that's 385 frames and we have animated everything. But we need to do a few more simple things. Select the whole left leg together with the platform and move the frames, for example 10 frames to the right, just to offset the legs so they don't move precisely together, because you want to see if the legs don't affect each other. If you look here, you can see that the green leg is affecting the blue leg, but it shouldn't. And if they both moved exactly at the same time, you wouldn't be able to see that. We also need to mirror the animation for the arms, because we animated just one side. That is easy. Just select any bone from the green arm, right click, save anim, frame 0 to 385, select a bone of the blue arm, load anim, and OK. So the keys are here, it got copied. But the arm is still not moving, because cat needs to update, which is probably a bug. But just rotate it and move it, and it should fix it. Now both arms are symmetrical. We don't need to offset them like we did with the legs, because they are far away from each other and don't affect themselves, so it's fine. Okay, and the last thing. We want to do it also for the eyebrows. Select the bone, save anim, 0 to 385, load anim, check mirror and frame 0, move to update and done. Next one, load anim, 0, mirror, move and done. And the same thing for the rest of the bones. I will speed this up here a bit, because you know what's up already. After we are done with this, we have a complete skin test animation done and we can move to actually skinning the mesh. I know this wasn't the most exciting episode of all time, because we were just animating all the bones, but it could not be skipped either way. You have to get through this if you want to skin the model properly. Well great, that's it. In the next episode we will finally start skinning, so come back tomorrow to check it out. I'm Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.